Are there things that even a time machine can't change? Moments which become solidified after certain conditions are met, like the unavoidable death of a friend or the eventual outbreak of war. And if that's the case, what exactly makes them impossible to change? These questions drive a lot of the narrative for Steins Gate, and its answers to these questions are what make the series one of the most highly regarded sci-fi anime. In the future, scientists from 2036 have successfully modeled the structure of the universe. There are many potential world lines, but only one is active at a time, and each world line is within an attractor field, which contains convergence points. But what does all of that mean? Why is it significant to the events of the story? And does that actually prevent you from making certain changes? Welcome to Anime Science, where we look at science fiction concepts in anime, see how accurate they are in reality, and how weird we could get with them. This episode is based on Steins Gate and includes topics like world lines, the many worlds interpretation, fixed point attractors, superpositions, and time travel metaphysics. There are some other videos about Steins Gate here on my channel, but you largely don't need to watch those in order to watch this. But of course, I highly recommend checking those out first. Keep in mind, I'm not a physicist or anything like that. I'm just an anime nerd with a computer science degree that likes to break down complex ideas. If you have a better understanding of the concepts covered in this video, feel free to leave a comment down below. Let's start with world lines. A world line traces an object's path through space-time. It's essentially an entire record of an object throughout its duration. More specifically in Steins Gate, this is used to represent the many possible states of the universe, including all of its events over time. To simplify this, the world line is conceptually the same as a timeline, as the current state of the universe depends on its events in time. In his 1957 dissertation, Hugh Everett proposed the many worlds interpretation. This is the idea that multiple worlds can exist at the same time using quantum mechanics. This gives us the common theory of parallel worlds, which can represent an infinite or non-definable amount of deterministic outcomes. In other words, every possible version of the universe could exist. When you apply this idea to Steins Gate, then every time Okabe makes a time-based change, his existence shifts onto the new corresponding world line. Or more accurately, the altered world line itself shifts into existence and replaces the previous world line entirely. This process changes everything to the results of this new world line, except for Okabe's memories because he has his reading Steiner ability. Sometimes the change in the world line is small enough such that certain key events are not affected. This causes many world lines to be similar based on those events. For example, a person with a medical issue might always die on a specific day unless they're treated before a certain period, though similar versions of the world line are considered part of a grouping known as an attractor field. This is a fictional concept unique to Steins Gate, and it's essentially a way to categorize these world lines. An attractor field itself is functionally the same as a world line, but only focuses on those key events that make the world lines within it similar. Each world line is different, but the attractor field moves in the same overall direction. These key events in an attractor field are known as convergence points, which are moments that must happen on these similar world lines. No matter how different a world line may seem, they will always converge at these points that relate to their attractor field, meaning that certain defined events occur in all of these world lines, but how they happen, or what happens after, doesn't have to be the same. The biggest example in Steins Gate is Mayuri's death, which is a convergence point for all world lines within attractor field Alpha. How she dies doesn't matter, only that the death itself happens. It is unavoidable while remaining within attractor field Alpha. Attractor fields and convergence points are based on mathematical concepts known as attractors and fixed points. An attractor is a set of states that a dynamic system tends to evolve towards given a wide range of starting parameters, and a fixed point is a value that doesn't change during a transformation. One of the more common types of attractors is a fixed point attractor, which combines these concepts. This means a system will tend to reach a state which may or may not contain a fixed point. An initial set of starting parameters tends to result in similar states, but they aren't guaranteed, which means a dynamic system such as a world line isn't forced to have these fixed points. In Steins Gate, not reaching these fixed points is essentially the same as changing attractor fields. To demonstrate how this model works in the visual novel, Suzuha uses several colored strings of yarn. Each string represents an attractor field, and each thread in the string is a world line. She then twists all of the yarn pieces together, displaying a fat, multicolored string as the final result, visually displaying how every possible world line is within several possible attractor fields, and each attractor field will also converge with each other at some point. This is essentially how the Steins Gate universe is structured. Suzuha also says that this model cherry-picks from the many worlds interpretation and the Copenhagen interpretation. So let's go over what all that means. Both of these theories of quantum mechanics deal with wave functions, and a wave function describes the probability of a particle's quantum state. This function is used to determine the current state of a quantum system. In the Copenhagen interpretation, it's believed that a wave function contains all possible states, but that the wave collapses onto a single state when it's observed. Meanwhile, the many worlds interpretation suggests that the waves don't actually collapse, but that all possible states actually happen across different universes. Let's look at the famous Schrödinger's cat example with both theories. You have a cat in a box with a random chance of being poisoned. When you open the box, will the cat be alive or dead? With the Copenhagen interpretation, it is only one result of either alive or dead, but with the many worlds interpretation, it is alive in one universe and dead in another, meaning there is one result in each universe, but all results happen across all potential universes. Now, Suzuha specifically clarifies that these world lines are not parallel worlds, but possibilities that exist simultaneously. The world lines are superpositioned together, which is a quantum mechanics concept that means something can be in several states at the same time until it is observed. For example, a normal computer bit can only be a 0 or a 1, but a quantum bit can be both 0 and 1 at the same time until a program checks its current state. This is a real thing, by the way. So in this story, every world line is possible, but only one is observed to exist at a time. Steins Gate relies heavily on the many worlds interpretation to explain all of its possible world lines, and it uses the Copenhagen interpretation to say that the world lines don't actually exist in parallel. But from what I understand, the logic it uses to bring them together is sort of incorrect. The Copenhagen interpretation itself has no explanation for what happens to all the other states that aren't chosen. The many worlds interpretation answers this problem by saying that those states also happen, but just in different universes which also exist in parallel. So the many worlds interpretation itself is already an extension to the Copenhagen interpretation. And to remove the idea that it's parallel would also undo what makes the many worlds interpretation unique from the Copenhagen interpretation. Everett's theories about many worlds say we only believe one world exists at a time because we only perceive one outcome. So they could exist in parallel, but the main problem is that we have no way to prove it. But the tip section in the visual novel for Steins Gate Zero says definitively that its world lines don't exist in parallel. Whether or not that's scientifically accurate is currently impossible to prove, and no explanation is given in the series for how this is actually proven by future scientists in Steins Gate. But because Okabe has reading Steiner, none of this really matters anyways, since it kind of equalizes a lot of the problems related to the worlds being parallel. In order to know the exact world line they're on, future Okabe creates the divergence meter. This device is a series of Nixie tubes and glowing mesh wires, which displays a sequence of numbers. These numbers represent a way to identify the current world line. Its value is not calculated in real time, but instead set manually by Okabe during its creation. This makes the device useless to everyone except Okabe, since only he can notice world line changes. The difference in its numbers is likely based on each slight variation of the future Okabe that will create the divergence meter, and his reading Steiner ability might also play a significant role in its creation. For example, he could be mindful of the number of times he has created it, and then set values based on that. Also, the events of each world line are predetermined during its creation, so every time Okabe uses the time leap machine, before he does anything, the divergence number would be different. Even if he completely replicates an iteration of events, just the knowledge that he's done this before is enough to change the overall value by at least a tiny amount. This means it is impossible to remain on the same world line with any time-based change, and it's also impossible to return to the same exact world line after you shifted out of it. You could go to extremely similar world lines, but never the exact same world line. Now, any change related to time will affect the world line, but shifting attractor fields is where it gets trickier. Because every event on the world line is predetermined, you can't actually change the world line itself. Technically, you can only change which world line is currently active. Likewise, you can't actually change the attractor field itself, you can only change which attractor field is currently active. So the only way to save Mayuri is to shift into a world line that isn't within attractor field alpha. In the story for Steins Gate, the main way to change his attractor fields is through creating a divergence. This is where you change the past in a way that a convergence no longer happens, or cannot possibly happen. When this happens, the world line has to correct itself by shifting into one that fits the logic of what has been established. And since the events of the world line are now influenced in various ways through time travel devices, sometimes this causes a chain reaction of time-based changes. For example, Okabe sending his initial D-mail shifted him into attractor field alpha because the message eventually notified CERN that someone had a time travel device. This alters not only their actions, but also knowledge possession and usage of a time machine. machine. So much so that just the act of deleting this email from their database in the present somehow changes the past. Most likely because it would cause a chain reaction of time-based changes that now no longer happen, so the world line is corrected. But this logic is also one of the more debated plot points among fans of the series, especially considering how each world line is supposed to be predetermined, which could mean the D-mail would have always been deleted and a correction like this wouldn't happen. It gets a bit confusing when you think about it, so let's just move on from that. So the divergence needed to shift Attractor Field seems incredibly difficult, but that's mostly to keep the plot interesting. In theory, Attractor Fields would be very easy to change, especially the further back in time you make a change, and there would be far more Attractor Fields than we're led to believe, and preventing Mayuri's death wouldn't be impossible to achieve using the time leap machine, despite it being a central part of the story. But in Steins Gate, the Attractor Field is mostly used as an excuse for the universe to correct inconsistencies. The reason Mayuri has to die is because her death is what causes Okabe to create the actual time machine in the future. Suzuha then uses the time machine to be a part of the main story. This means Suzuha's existence in the past is directly tied with the death of Mayuri, solidifying this event as a convergence of the Attractor Field. But that said, there's a lot of problems that go along with that, like the assumption that the time machine will only be made if Mayuri dies, or that the exact way Mayuri dies doesn't drastically impact the future. And it also ignores how Okabe's mental state begins to deteriorate after countless attempts at changing the past. Because of how far in the future Suzuha comes from, all these slight differences in how the convergence point happened could result in a number of drastic changes. And keep in mind, these events don't technically have to happen, it's just what's required to be considered a part of a certain Attractor Field. So if you know for a fact that you're within Attractor Field Alpha, then Mayuri's death will happen. But if for some reason her death doesn't happen, then you aren't in Attractor Field Alpha. Make sense? I hope so. Undoing the first D-mail brings Okabe into the Beta Attractor Field, but now Karisu dies instead of Mayuri, so their goal becomes finding a way to reach Steins Gate, a theoretical world line where neither Mayuri nor Karisu die. Since this conflicts with both Alpha and Beta Attractor Fields, they essentially have to create a new Attractor Field, and the main way to do this is to cause a divergence at the exact moment of a convergence point. In the story, the key to reaching Steins Gate is to deceive the world at the moment of Karisu's death, meaning that they only need to make it appear like she died to Okabe, which implies that Karisu never had to die for this convergence point. All that's important is the appearance of her death. Personally, I'd argue that actually her death, or its appearance, probably isn't a convergence point at all. No, what's more important is the fate of her stolen time travel research. Originally, she dies and her father steals her research and defects to Russia, and this eventually sets into motion World War III. So what really creates a divergence is replacing a metal Upa with a plastic one, which leads to the stolen research burning away in a plane crash, meaning Karisu doesn't have to die, it just tended to happen as a side effect of her father stealing her research. And this was only observed during the couple times Okabe attempted to change these events. But that said, this whole part also involves the actual time machine, which kind of has its own unique differences with how it affects the world line, but I'll talk about that more in a future video. Convergence points make sense when looking at Attractor Field classifications, but what I don't like is the idea that these events can become seemingly impossible to prevent after a certain point. Let's look at the most notable convergence points. Mayuri's death is unavoidable at its moment in Attractor Field Alpha. The way she dies is irrelevant, only the fact that she dies matters. But with Karisu, her death itself isn't an absolute because only the perception of her death seems to be important. Which begs the question, shouldn't it be far easier to create new Attractor Fields? How significant does a change have to be in order to affect the world line enough to create new convergence points? For example, how come Mayuri's death was explicitly portrayed as an entirely unchangeable outcome? She's killed by hitmen, pushed in front of a train, shot by cops, turned into jelly, and at one point she just has a heart attack? Cause that happened? Okabe tried everything, even moving to South America and admitting Mayuri to a hospital, but the result never changes. While he's in Attractor pressure field alpha, Mayuri will always die. As I mentioned before, this is most likely to avoid a potential paradox with Suzuha being there, but there's no reason the world line can't be corrected to one where Suzuha still goes there without Mayuri dying. And when you take everything into account, you come to the conclusion that there can't be unavoidable convergence points in the Steins Gate universe, meaning that there does exist a world line where Mayuri somehow survives her convergence point death, and we never have to deal with Kurisu dying. There should be a way to diverge the world line by starting a new attractor field during Mayuri's convergence point. Instead, this death is presented as unavoidable, as an excuse for narrative drama, which personally I'm fine with for the story, but it does make its presentation seem logically inaccurate. However, the newest entry to the science adventure franchise may introduce more ideas to how the Steins Gate universe works. The story of Anonymous Code is centered around multi-layered simulations. At some point, a simulation of the world is created, and then another simulation is created within that simulation. The implication is that this could theoretically have gone on forever, and that their world itself is likely a simulation too. This gives us the concept of world layers as opposed to world lines. Where Steins Gate is about infinitely horizontal worlds, Anonymous Code is about infinitely vertical worlds. The newest protagonist, Pollen, can manipulate the current world layer by using his unique ability, the literal save and load features of the game itself, which makes sense because a game is technically a simulation. Anonymous Code isn't out yet in the West, so it's hard for me to speculate the exact details of how that universe works. But it has been confirmed that it exists within the same universe as Steins Gate, specifically in the Beta Attractor field. So the implication could be that Steins Gate also takes place within a simulation, and in that case, the metaphysics of how its time travel works could be vastly different. But like I said, Anonymous Code isn't available in the West yet, so most of us have to wait until 2023. To find out more about that. I've already pre-ordered my copy though, so I'm excited. Anyways, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. These videos take a lot of time and motivation for me to research, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you're interested in more sci-fi anime discussions, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Leave any comments, questions, or concerns in the comments below. And if you want to hang out or maybe even help me with future anime science episodes, come join my Discord server. We have a good time there. And if you want to directly support my content, check out my Patreon. Maybe someday I'll make enough money there to do this full time. Maybe it already happened in another world line. You never know.